So there's been so much talk about screening, right? Mm-hmm. We're all over the place. At first we said one thing and then another, and it was 40, then 50, then 45, and all of this stuff. What do you tell patients or even colleagues? I get that asked all the time. You know, when should I start screening? What do you answer for them?
I think you hit it right on the nail. Like, it's been so confusing. Mm-hmm. Different organizations are saying different things.
Yeah.
And even the guidelines are changing.
All the time.
So, all the time. So, I think I generally go with the national guidelines of American Cancer Society and NCCN that who basically say, start at age 40.
Yeah.
For most patients, but they need to have a discussion that sometimes, yes, there are false positives, and yes, yeah. Sometimes they end up needing biopsies that maybe you wouldn't have otherwise.
Yeah.
But it leads to less cancers going undiagnosed for too long.
Right.
If they start at 40. Another question that I get asked all the time is, so which one now? Is it mammogram? Is it ultrasound? Mammogram is radiation. Can I just do ultrasound or MRI? What do you tell to women there?
Well, I think it's just like the screening, right? It's not one size fits all, right? And so mammogram is really good. People always say, well, it's because a man invented it. That's why we're not improving on it, and it hurts. And yes, you're right, it hurts, it's not great. I've had mammograms, I'm sure you've had mammograms, but that's kind of the best way to find those little tiny calcifications, right? Which is the earliest signs of cancer. You can't see it on an ultrasound, and often you can't even see it on an MRI. So I tell patients they're kind of complementary to each other, right? Mammogram is the gold standard. We know we could find a lot of stuff, but there are some people who have breast tissue that's more challenging when it comes to mammographs. You can't see as much. I often will bring up the image and show them what the density looks like and tell them what it looks like and how the radiologists are looking for things. So you understand the complexity behind it and why some people have more biopsies, right? Because you don't want to miss anything. But on the flip side, you don't want to do too many biopsies and you're becoming a pincushion. So.
Yeah.
I do kind of walk through why a mammogram is important and how ultrasound can be complementary, right? So if you have very dense breast tissue, you want to do ultrasound. And you do them together so they kind of give you a better picture. It's kind of like seeing the same thing from two different angles.
Correct.
Right. But what about MRI? Everybody now is asking me, I want an MRI. Everybody gets an MRI.
Everybody gets a full body MRI.
Right.
No, it's very true. So. You just have to figure, you know, understand that, like you said, different things are complementary to each other.
Right.
So I would say mammogram for, you know, anyone who's above 40 for the most part, a 3D mammogram, which is also called tomosynthesis.
Right.
And then ultrasound, like you said, if they're dense, that would be complementary. It's probably overkill for a lot of patients. I would save that for people who have a genetic mutation, have a history of, you know, breast cancer, let's say, different types of breast cancer, if there's already diagnosed, those need MRIs.
Yeah.
But not everybody needs an MRI, and probably leads to far more biopsies than, you know, that actually saves someone from cancer.
Exactly. It shows us blood flow. Mm-hmm. Right. I had a patient who had an MRI who did it at the wrong time of the month. And their breast lit up like a Christmas tree just because of the physiologic changes that normally happens in the breast. And then they're stuck going, well, what do I do with this? I think she was like signed up for a bilateral mastectomy. And we're like, whoa.
Yes.
Right? Let's take a step back and let's do it at the right time when the breast is quiet.
Right.
And all of a sudden there was nothing that was seen. So that's, you know, just understanding how each of those imaging modalities shows us things. It doesn't show us cancer. It's not like you do that image and it's like cancer, right?
Right.
And there's some limits to it. So I think once you understand how things work, then it's easier to decide for yourself, which is kind of the best way to go.
Right. And the radiation from mammogram is very, very small.
Very small.
So I wouldn't be concerned about that at all. I keep telling people, you don't be concerned about that. That's completely okay.
Right.
And you want to find these precancerous things that only show up on mammogram. You can't find them in MRI. We're not just doing MRI because it's expensive.
Right.
Mammogram actually shows these things when MRI doesn't.
Right. And you know, you hear all these people say, oh, well, I should just do a sonocine and I don't need a mammogram. But it has to be a mass before you find it on sonocine. And mammograms can find it before you find a mass. So I think it's just important to understand what each of those imaging modalities show us and how it's helpful so that we can put it all together to help patients. I mean, the goal is to find it early.
Right.
The earlier we find cancers, the more options we have, right? When it comes to taking care of patients.
And that's your mammogram.
Yes.